Let's color some awesome green hair. I'm going to use the Faber-Castell Black Edition this time. I selected a couple of colors, starting with a white one, and in some parts I will end up with a black one. This is one from the Caran d'Ars Luminance set because my black from the Faber-Castell is run out, so I'm going to mix them together. I think the Black Edition is a wonderful pencil to start with if you are not an experienced colorist or if you do not want to spend so much money on your coloring pencils. I think it's an excellent brand, and well, I love to show you why that is. I am always starting with the white parts. I will explain why. If you are starting with the white and you are want to color over it again and make it darker, you will notice that that is almost impossible. So if you have some parts, you want to make sure that they are going to stay really, really light. Use your white and use it as an advantage. So I will show you what I mean. If I would color white in this page and I would color over it with my green, you can see what is happening. You see, it won't mix anymore. It's going to take up a little bit of the green, but you're going to keep seeing this white stain. You can make use of it. You can use it in your backgrounds if you want to make stars or white spots or whatever. You can do that. So only use the white if you are very certain you want to keep that areas as light as possible, and do it before you do everything else, because then you are making sure you won't ruin it later on. So maybe that's a good trick. Now I'm starting to look at the shades of gray, and I will build my way up from the lightest area we have done and start looking for different colors. This is a relatively dark grayscale. I make this book myself, and I think the darker ones are always very easy to color because the shading is very obvious. And if you are a beginner in grayscale coloring, or you simply want to color without thinking what you are doing, well, I always love to do a grayscale like this, because it shows the dark and lights really, really well. If you are coloring it and you start to see that your coloring pencil isn't covering up the gray anymore, then you are probably using a too light color. It is really possible to color these dark pages with all the black in it. I hear a lot of people are saying you can't color it. Yes, you can, but you simply need to know how. And it shows that your pencil does not have to be an expensive one, because lots of new brands like this one, the Faber-Castell Black Edition, is not an expensive pencil, and they are made for coloring these darker pages. So it's actually kind of fun. Like the ears I have done yesterday, this was almost black, and I colored it with dark blue. If I would have tried to do this on a very light grayscale, yeah, well, it's very complicated to get that almost black tone. So yeah, it is possible, but you simply need to know how. And well, I hope by showing this that you are thinking, well, let's give it a try and maybe I can do it myself, and maybe you surprise yourself, because it is not so expensive. Difficult as you would might think. Let's see that I'm not coloring in a way you can't see it. It's always a bit of a challenge. The camera is hanging above this page and I'm working in between it. And I'm trying not to mess up my coloring because I'm wearing reading glasses and I can't get as close to the paper as I normally do, so it's a bit of a challenge. I am looking for all the lighter areas because I always go for larger contrast like I did in the ears and on the face. One good thing to know, it's an excellent pencil, but they ruin your sharpener. I have bought this one, the Faber-Castell, that has three holes, and this one is excellent for this pencil. If you are using a like the Dahle pencil sharpener, don't do it because they tend to ruin your sharpener. So if you do, buy an extra one only for these pencils. I have no idea why they make them in such a strange shape, but they did. And well, that's the only thing I hate about them. I'm going to go to the second color of green, a little bit darker. And basically I am starting with the other parts left. And I'm going to color the second shade of gray I see now. Always add on some of my own. That's always good. I'm trying to do this a little bit less complicated. This is a book with, well, let's show you. It's this book, the Dreamland Sketches. It has lots of fun pages, lots of different ones, not so complicated, but just interesting enough to give you awesome results. And because it is not such a complicated book, I'm going to try it in a way it is doable for everyone. And it's a fantasy book, so you can do lots of strange things. That's why I am giving you a green hair, because I think that is way more nice than a simple blonde girl or a brunette or whatever. Playing a little bit with color is always fun. And in a fantasy page, you can do everything you want. So, always try to go for the stranger things. That's the fun about it. But always keep in mind, start really light and really dark and everything in between. And then you will end up with a awesome coloring. Then it doesn't matter what color you are choosing, but go for contrast. And then it will be really pretty. I always think ahead when I'm starting. I have colored her ears red, and I use the same colors in here and in her eyes. And I'm adding on green now, but later on the tentacles I will make in the same color like this. The jewelry I'm going to do with a little bit of green. And the clothes I will probably go for a purplish red to give her that gothic vibe. And, well, and do not want to use so many colors, because I do not think that's very pretty. Always think ahead. It's never pretty when your colors aren't matching. Try to have an idea where you are going, and that's, you will end up with a prettier result. If you have trouble finding your own colors, you can also buy boxes with cards of colors, but you can also find them on Pinterest. They are way more cheaper and they have lots of color ideas. So if you are struggling, you can always lend some inspiration there and stick to the colors. And sometimes you find some new things also that you never have thought of yourself. So, that's my advice. Like I said, this is a coloring book I made myself. It's a book by Dreamworld Coloring. I am selling books on Etsy, where you can buy the digital ones, and a real book on Amazon. I'm coloring in the Amazon book now because there are still lots of people thinking that Amazon books are no good and you can't color it. Well, actually, I think they have improved their books a lot lately. Of course, some books that are more expensive, they have different paper. And yes, I agree, that colors a little bit, better. But on the other side, they are more expensive also. And, well, sometimes that's is not so nice to buy always books that are 25 or 30 euros or dollars. And, well, Amazon, they are more affordable. And if you know what to buy, some are actually really good. So, but if you do want to print them yourself, it's also possible. I prefer to print my books also, because then I can choose my paper. But on the other hand, you have got printer problems and, well, all kinds of things that are not so fun. And, well, I have to say, holding a actual book like this, it has always something special, I think. So, yeah. I am always using covers on my books, colored by customers. Like this one is colored by Nanu, and she made an excellent one. I always try to show you what is possible by coloring it myself or showing work of others, and not use a picture with a result that, well, it's simply too hard to achieve yourself. So, yeah, I hope that really helps. It's kind of complicated now, because I am trying not to overcomplicate what I'm doing. And that's a challenge, because, I was looking already for lots of different colors I could use, but let's keep this relatively simple but pretty. So if you want to try it yourself, you see how easy it is. But for me, sometimes doing less complicated, that's quite challenging. So, but so far I think it's going well. She's getting pretty green and pretty. I'm skipping to another color. It's a dark one. Let's see what will happen. Turn my book around. Hope you can still see it. I wasn't being able to do lots of workshop the last few months because it was pretty dark outside. All the time gray and gloomy weather. So it was too dark inside to make a good video. But better times are now ahead, so it must be possible again. It's always fun to show the things that are possible. When I create a coloring book, I think it really helps that I am coloring myself. I am always looking for lots of details, because I think that is more interesting to color. Too much of the same is boring. The end result maybe is very pretty, but it has to be fun also while you are working. So I hope you agree with me that this is an interesting page to color. If I am blending over the part that I've already colored, I simply press a little less hard. And sometimes I'm using my pencil that I had before to blend two colors in together. Later on, I'm going to blend in with a liquid solution. But for now, I am trying to get it as pretty as I can, because that will make the end result way more pretty. And it also shows that you can also blend with your pencils. And the Faber-Castell Black Edition does it excellent. I am also tried it with the Bloedvoener pencils. It's also a relatively cheap brand of pencils. They are pretty decent for what you pay for them, but they end up sometimes a little bit waxy. And I think that the Black Edition are a bit better. But the Bloedvoener has way more colors, so that's the upside of that brand. And they are actually pretty good. I never would have imagined that a cheap pencil could color this well. Of course, if you have an expensive brand, they are better. It would be strange if they were not. But, well, it's simply not for everyone because they are really expensive. So I am very happy that there is an alternative for everyone. I have given lots of real-time workshops and, well, people who wanted to start, and they are always not very happy when they have to invest in a really expensive coloring box. But this makes it more for everyone, and then you can make up your mind if you like it enough to invest in a more expensive brand. I am using a affiliated link on my videos lately. I get a little money of it if you buy something through that link. That helps me to show all those new things because, well, I do have to buy them and it costs a lot of money. But I do not get rich from it. It's simply helping me a little bit better in showing you all those things that are available. And yeah, I wanted to explain that. And I also like to add, I am very honest. If I do not like it, I'm going to tell you and I will not going to use it. So yeah, I will never show you something I do not like. Checking if the paper is still in the middle. It would be a shame if I would be coloring outside of the frame and you can't see it anymore. I also have a Facebook group with one of my coloring friends. She makes books too, and we have a group called Dream World Coloring and Cray World Coloring, and there we have lots of live coloring. Is that the correct English term? We have lots of workshops there, fun things, and well, yeah, if you want to join us, that would be very fun. Lots of things to learn there. You can also show all your work there. I think it's a fun group to be part of. So everything to do about coloring or being creative with coloring pages. Now my group member, Corey, also loves to show lots of other things you can do with your colored papers. So lots of ideas there. So I was neglecting YouTube a little bit, so I am trying to correct it and showing you a little bit more of this colorings. I think I am talking a little bit too much. I'm filling up the edges with my darkest green. I will end up a little bit of black later on. But for now, I'm going to stick with this darker green. I think it looks pretty decent. Here, oh, I forgot a piece of this. And here, she's starting to look pretty decent, I think. I love this picture. Oh, that's my dog. If you hear strange noises or barking, it's always my dog. I have a big dog, so he can make a lot of noise. I really hope he's not going to do that now. That would be a shame. Of course he is. He's always doing that when I'm coloring. Let's sharpen my pencil. If you're coloring hair, don't forget to sharpen your pencil on a regular basis, because you cannot color hair with a blunt pencil. So they are perfect for those detailed hairs. It's an excellent pencil to color. And as you can see, you can cover up this almost black areas pretty good. They are designed to do so, and it's almost unbelievable that it is even possible, because they do it very well. So you see, it is pretty black, and I'm coloring it away so easily. I made a small mistake here. I colored a little bit over the ear. That's stupid, but well, we're not going to pay attention to it so much. Maybe I should have mentioned it to you, because now you know. And here we have a small piece. It's getting really well. Forgot a part here. Let's sharpen this one. I'm so not happy with the shape of this pencil. I really do not know how they ever could have chosen this shape, because so far I haven't heard from anyone liking it. It's actually complicated to sharpen, but well, that's the only downside about them, so maybe I should not complain. Let's concentrate a little bit on the single hairs. I'm talking way too much, then I make some sloppy mistakes, and so filling this up again. This time I'm not coloring over her ear, at least I'm trying so. So, and here we're going to add on a little bit of this green. You see, I keep saying it covers up the gray so easily, and it was so dark. If I would color this on a light area, it is so complicated to get it this shade of green. That's no fun. So the dark tones actually help make your coloring look way prettier, especially when you are coloring a more grayscale page like this. Then it sets the mood for your coloring. So I am always use a little bit more black in the original pages then. Okay, let's see. Got the shading here, you see lots of almost black here, and I'm wearing my wrong glasses, can't see it. I have, when it's darker in the house for nighttime and daytime, and I'm wearing my nighttime glasses now, so it's a little bit more challenging to see, but I think it looks good. Like I said, I'm doing this the easy way, in a not overcomplicated way, coloring easy green hair. It's always fun coloring things in a different color. Let's sharpen it again. You see there are some details, some darker lines. Hairs always have a beginning and an end. So do not press so hard and make gentle lines, and do not stop. I mean, this, if you're doing this, you've got a very harsh line. Start gentle, press a little harder and let it flow over like this. If you do not press so hard, you will end up with tiny lines. Never do this. That's ugly. So be gentle. And always remember, a hair has a beginning and an end. And it never stops in the middle of her head. So I hope I'm explaining myself. But take your time. This is not so detailed, so this is relatively easy, but sometimes there are way more details in it. And then you have to take your time to color it. But it basically, it are all lines. That's everything you have to do. So it just takes time. If you want to end up with an excellent coloring, you have to be patient. And if you are, you will get great results. I always, when I am coloring myself and I am noticing that I cannot concentrate anymore, I put it aside. It doesn't have to be finished in one day. So take your time, then you will end up with the best pages. Okay, well, let's add on a little bit more of the black. And let's see if I am in. Here, where the shading was the darkest, I am going over it with a little bit of black. Just black and white are pencils I use a lot. And black is also is always making the darkest color just a little bit darker. And like here on the edges, just add on a little bit more and you make a even darker green. Always be gentle with black, not use too much, because when you are going to blend, it will go a long way. And if you use too much, you will blend away all the lighter areas we are tried so hard to get in this picture. So be gentle. Like this part, add a little bit of more, I am lost my line. And what I was trying to say is use a little bit of the black. English is not my native language, so sometimes when I'm coloring and concentrating, it's kind of complicated to come up with the right words. So if it sounds funny, then well, yes, I can understand, because but I'm doing my very best. And you can always put the sound off and just watch. Maybe that's a good idea too. I never listen back when I am finished a video, because I do not like listening to myself. I hope you do. Here, this part, I am going over it with some black, a little bit. Sometimes you have pencils that are so dark, a very dark green, but in this box they are not. So you can make it yourself by mixing the colors together. You could also choose a dark blue and go over it. That's pretty also. Just play a little bit with it and you will be fine. Here, underneath, we can use some black. And here, and the way this hair comes from behind the face, you always know that you have to use lots of shading. Not so much, but a little bit. And here we do the same. I press a little harder at the beginning and I start pressing less on my pencil when I am letting it flow over in the other green. So you do not have to press very hard on your pencil. always be gentle. It's very complicated if you put a lot of pressure on your pencil to get it very blended again. That's very complicated and you do not need to press so very hard. This pencil colors very, very gentle. I haven't colored for a while with this wand because sometimes I forget that I have them, and I was almost forgotten how fun they are coloring. So yeah, I will try to show you as much pencil brands as possible. I will be giving way more videos away like this, some fun and small parts, not too complicated, and I will show you lots of new materials and pencils. Well, I think we are almost there. Let's go to the fun part. I always love to blend. I am using a liquid solution for this. Gamsol is very nice, and I am using a paper stump and a sandpaper thingy. If you start doing this, put your finger on the tip, go over the sandpaper and make a sharp tip, and rub away the color you used before, otherwise you will make a big stain, and that's not what you want. Dip it a little bit in the liquid solution and start blending. You can also do it with a cotton tip, but if you have more detailed work, that's sometimes a little bit complicated, so I prefer a paper stump like this. But if I am doing larger areas, I am using a cotton tip. Then it is relatively easy. So you see, if you are starting to color and you find it so complicated to blend with your pencils, then you can see what is happening when you are blending it with a liquid solution. Then it's a little bit like magic. It's getting to look so smooth and the colors blend in so perfectly. Always clean it in between if you have done a darker area, because otherwise you will rub it over your lightest parts and you do not want that. It can look a little bit grayish when you are doing this, especially when you are blending lighter colors, but it is simply because the paper is getting wet, so then you know that you do not have to be afraid. When I did it the first time, I thought, oh help, I have ruined my coloring. I was doing skin tones and they were turning, well, gray. And that was a little bit scary, but it turned out fine, so you know. Always be gentle. Use it a little bit in a way you would use your coloring pencil. Rub it in the way the hair goes. Never like this here, but let it flow in the way of the lines of the hair, and then it will be pretty. And yeah, this is relatively easy. This hair, oh, I've forgotten one. You see, she has one here. Let's do that, and here, yeah. Green hairs in her face. And we are going to do the same thing here. Can you still see it? Yes, you can. Always going a little bit over this area. You can also use a skin tone for it, but I am working it a little bit in there, so it gives a little bit color there, and that's just enough. It does not need to be more. Okay, let's see if we can do this. Don't go outside of the outer lines, because it's not so easy to get rid of. I hope it shows how easy it is to color this dark grayscale, and that it actually makes sense that it is the way it is, that it adds up to the end result of the coloring. I am always a little bit annoyed. Sometimes I get a bad review of, because people say, I can't color this, it's way too dark, too much black areas. And well, I think that's a little bit unfair, but it's just the way it's supposed to look for me. And I show always the backside of my pages, and it gives a clear view of what you are buying. So if you think they are too black, don't buy them, I always think, because I do show it. I know lots of people who sell the books on Amazon, they do not show very well what you can expect on the inside. I am not doing that. I'm always showing what you buy. The cover on the front is an actual colored page, and made by a customer, and the ones on the back give you a pretty good view on what is in the inside of the book. So I hope that is helpful for you, because I know Amazon has a bad reputation, but there are a lot of interesting books, so sometimes you have to do a little bit more investigation before you buy something. But then I think, yes, you can buy so many pretty things there, and so much to choose from lately. So yeah, if you love coloring, well, then I know a nice coloring book will make you happy. At least it makes me happy all the time. Pencils, coloring books, and shoes. Let's not forget shoes, that's important. I will use a little bit more here. I think that's pretty. You can always do that, eh? You can always use a little bit more dark on the areas like this. But like I said, on the very light areas, was where we use the white, there it is very complicated to get it darker. But now you've seen what has happened. I've blended over it. It's not so white anymore. It has a hint of green, just enough, but we keep those light spots like I wanted it before, so I think that's pretty decent. Well, let's see, what did we make? We started with a white, we ended up with a black, and I used this one, and this one. These are the pencils I have used for my page. I can do it better. I will use a extra sheet, and I will write down the numbers of the green I used. So if you want, you can try it yourself. And I really hope you liked it. And thank you for watching.